Let's see here. I think Dak is pretty strong. Swift Spear is fine if we go mono red or like red blue spells. Shredder's pretty strong. I might just take Bloodstained Mire. I think Dak's good enough. Actually, let's just take this white card. Get past no white cards. I like Inquisition a lot. There's a Coalition Relic. We can take Batterskull if we're trying to go white. Pick up a Stoneforge. Flooded Strand, Revoker. And take Inquisition. Actually, the Mana Drain's pretty crazy. Weird that there's no blue in this pack. They're passing Mana Drain. And Proxy's pretty much blue, but... I mean, the white's not crazy good. Take Duress. Priest is fine. Could just be blue-black, though. I guess the black... I mean, the blue's dried up, or at least isn't opened in these packs. Might play Karn. Don't really care about these other cards. Priest is fine. Might play Karn, though. Okay. Well, the white's still here. But there's a Time Twister, Opposition, and Upheaval. All pretty strong. But very different strategies. I guess Time Twister and Upheaval could go in the same deck, hypothetically, but Opposition kind of stands alone. I guess I'll twist. I mean, it doesn't work super well with what we have. Maybe I should just take Opposition. Bone Shards now. Murktide. These packs have been weird. A couple duels, too. There's a Lion's Eye Diamond for a Twister. There's also a Grave Titan if we want to go Reanimator. I think I'll take Lion's Eye. Storm's open, it's open. There's the Brain Freeze. On the wheel. Not bad. I'm definitely not playing Thalia. If we go Storm. I mean, Sleeper's a very strong card if we're like heavy or black. I think I just take Triome. Sultai Triome's pretty good in Storm if you get like Oko or Leovold. Or even if you want to play like Heartbeat. Not terrible. Could take Silent Clearing. But I think I'm actually more likely to play Iona in some kind of Reanimator thing. I'm playing clearing. I guess we could have taken past in flames too. But whatever. There's the heartbeat. Take stomping ground. I don't know, I guess I'll take heartbeat. So what were our picks here? Thalia first. Into like Inquisition, Mana Drain, Duress, Time Twister, whatever. I don't think there was anything good in that pack. Hopefully there wasn't anything good. That's an opposition. I think it was something like this. Or maybe Karn was in here somewhere. Well, there's an Ashiok. I like Ashiok. Xander's Lounge for fixing. Also Lotus Bloom. We don't have to be Storm. It could just be blue-black. Yeah, I can't not take Ashiok. I also can't not take Remand. Remand goes in the Storm. We can still play Ashiok if we're storming, but yeah, easy remand. Skydiver, a lot of black cards here. Lily's pretty good. Yeah, I think I actually like Liliana here. Be a little bit more controlling, maybe. Just channel. There's a Tendrils too. I think I like Voidwalker actually. Voidwalker, Signet. Echo could work. We have Diamond. Possible Echo Wheels. We got Opposition late, Brain Freeze late. I'm gonna take this Signet. I don't really know about that one. Seeing as that we have zero creatures so far, I don't think Jitte is the pick. Take Treasure Cruise. We have some early stuff here. Tar Pit. Kind of like Treasure Cruise. Bayou, Grasp. Grasp seems good. Oh, there was a breach there. I guess we could have taken that. Try that archetype out. Harvester, Storm. I don't love Brutality outside of Reanimator. It just kind of does three things relatively poorly. If you're not discarding for value, it's a little lame. I think I still take it here though. It's either that or like Burgi or Pyromancer. Custody Lich. Could be alright. Also, also Lotus Bloom. Cloudscape. There's that Stoneforge. I don't think we're playing Braids. Iteration, possibly. I mean, we're getting some Storm cards for sure. Ponder or reanimate, those seem to be the choices here. Leaning towards ponder. We do have a decent setup for reanimator too. Can't go wrong with ponder. Vamp Tutor, Damnation, Signet. Yeah, I think we're leaning a little bit more towards Storm now. Don't really have much fast mana though. We have Brain Freeze, potential Thassa's Oracle on the wheel. I'm just going to take Signet. It's going to be good in either archetype. We can wield Damnation, Oracle, Tutor, even Foundry would be fine. Time Warp, Miscalc, Teferi. There's also a top. We'll get Thousand Year Storm with Time Warp. We just don't have a lot of like mana, which you need for Storm. We have Heartbeat, but it's kind of medium. Medium at best. I think I'm looking at Teferi, Miscalc, Time Warp. I think I actually like Teferi. We have the White Signet, we can maybe pick up some. We can luck into some white fixing. God, these mono white cards. Yeah, I'm gonna cut these. We might still play Iteration. Possibly play Time Twister, but I doubt it. Alright, what do we got here? Spire Bluff, Badlands. Nightmare, I don't think we need grief. Pretty good, I think I'll just take the fixing though. So this gets Swamp Island. This is a red duel though. I think we go Misty and like maybe we get a blue-white duel somehow. Or a blue-black duel like that. We already have Trion though. Animate Dead, Ophiomancer, Repeal. Ophiomancer doesn't do much. Besides, like, stave off aggro decks. Just take the duel. All right, Volcanic now. We're kind of rolling pretty good on the duels. But actually, there's Archmage and Scarab God, which Scarab God's a pretty good win con for this deck. I mean, we don't need to play the red. I think we just take the God. Archmage is crazy good, too. Might even be better. We just need ways to actually win, though, besides Ashiok. I guess if we could center it around Ashiok, we could just take Archmage. I'm gonna take the God. God, he's white. Emperor going late. Got another Signet. Probably just Fact or Fiction, though. Dimir Signet. There's a scrub land. We can't fetch for it, but it still fixes if we want to play Teferi. Not doing a ton with Baral. I would take Dimir Signet, but we're not really ramping into much. Take the white land. Damnation is a good wheel. Yeah, I mean, we got a lot of storm cards. We could try to squeeze in a Thassa's Oracle brain freeze thing. But I think we just take Damnation here, try to win with our Planeswalkers. Scarab God and whatnot. Might be a little too fair, but... I guess that technically makes Misty Rainforest a white duel, or a white fetch. It's kind of clunky though. So Toru, I didn't do much. I guess I'll take Nightmare. I only have four creatures though. Another black-white land. Citadel, maybe. Last pick, Coma. Alright, I guess we'll just add lands. This is actually worth playing. We can search for it with Misty as a white source if we need to. But it's like just like a bad plains otherwise. I don't know if it's worth it. I guess it does cycle. Not worried about it. Do we play a basic plains? See what this does. In before they go off on turn one. Yep. It's not really going off, but... Oh, that was stupid. Now I don't have anything to take with duress. I was gonna ponder anyway. That was stupid. I should have just duressed. I should have taken like the druid and then duressed the soul ring. That was stupid. Because now we're just going to have to kind of hope that they draw an on-creature spell at some point. They level up again instead of playing Reclaimer? What? Well, they also have a Reclaimer in their hand. I guess we know what we're discarding to bone shards. Now they're playing it instead of Druid. I don't understand their play. Alright, well, I'm happy to remain Questing Beast. Land, please. Thank you. So if we play Custody of Lich, they can just copy it with Metamorph, and then we have to sack it, and then they become the Monarch. If we play it now, they just sack Reclaimer. Don't really like that. And they can copy Scarab God. But we get first crack at unearthing like a Tree Speaker. Can also bounce it with Cloud's Gate. They might just replay Questing Beast too. I'll be happy to block it though. Okay, they go Druid plus. Plus Reclaimer activation. Weird. I can actually level him up. That's hilarious. Alright, he taps for 2 mana now. Wait, is he a 1/2? That's crazy. I didn't know how that worked. I guess he's a 1/2 now. We can't block Questing Beast with this anyway. That's funny. Does it actually change its power and toughness? I guess it does. It's showing 1/2. Let's see what they got here. They have a strip mine. Just a cradle. Okay. Just a cradle. So these are still the three cards in their hand, plus some unknown. I wouldn't have leveled up if I knew it was going to drop to a 1/2. Lesson learned, I guess. Okay, so they copy the god. What? What did they draw? They need so much mana. I guess they have finale or something? Oh, I guess they wouldn't really need to copy the god. They can't activate it. I'm not thinking. Scary. Twister, huh? I don't hate it, but I also don't love it. I'm gonna keep it on top. I'm not gonna play it this turn, though. I don't think. They didn't activate it, so I guess they don't have another crazy kooky land to get. Just pass. We don't want to get, we don't want to let them have Monarch. Uh-oh. Don't. Please tell me you just overtapped for Questing Beast. And that's all you have. Nope. Okay, good. That's acceptable. That's not... No, stop it. Stop. Okay. Deal? You have a scavenging use? Wait, did I miscount? Wow, I miscounted. Incredible. Unbelievable. I totally thought I could Scarab God and activate with Power Stone. Shit. It's really bad. Because now they get Monarch. We have no pressure. They get to leveler us. I guess I try to factor fiction for grasp. We get fuck all. No Teferi, no grasp. Masker Worm's good. Kills three other things. Drains them for six. But then what, you know? Now that we've got our hand up to, that's a grasp. So I guess we just wait till combat. So they can't unearth. They know we have mana drain. They probably still attack here just to get Monarch. Wow, no attacks. That's crazy. That's not how that works, friend. Oh man. Unless they're just getting it out so we can't scare them, God. I think they thought that they'd be able to destroy something, though. Don't really know why they would do that, though. Like, we have a 2/2 flyer and a elf. Like, it would be much better for them to attack with Courser, make us block. Like, I don't know. I think that was a shame scoop. Well, brutality definitely seems good against the elves. I also don't love Time Twister against them. Don't really have much to put in over it. I guess we can just play another land. Play a cycling land. I mean, it's a very fair hand, but not bad. They didn't show a strip mine or anything with, like, Reclaimer. They had a chance to go get it. Doesn't mean they definitely don't have it, but I'm not going to be scared of it, I don't think. Lead off with Island. We have 5 mana on turn 3, 6 mana on turn 3. Oh god. You got a Primus, Progenitus. It's pretty good too. No attacks for some reason. All forests, great. Now they're attacking. Okay. Now the coast is clear, apparently. Liliana is actually an answer for Progenitus, but obviously they have some chaff, so we're not going to get there. Alright, let's get some more info and scoop it up. Just a bunch of more lands. Okay, it turns out they're playing forests. That's good to know. Yep, Natural Order Progenitus sometimes just gets there. Oh, actually, I should have just discarded the garden with the bone shards. Should have played the godless shrine. I guess I can ditch the signet. Good, good, good. Alright, so they know we have the remand, but remand is remand, so. Unless they have, like, something uncounterable. Which, the only one I know about that's uncounterable is, like, coma. It's blue-green. So, they won't be playing natural order. Or if they do play natural order, then... I question their sanity. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, we have to remand that. So if they have a land, do they get to play it? Of course, we draw the thing that kills it. Alright. Yeah, I was gonna get the mana drain back. Keep Ashiok-ing. Alright, I'm gonna go to bed. Save these matches for tomorrow. Okay. So we're gonna continue the matches from yesterday. We played one match yesterday. Try to finish him up here. Looks pretty good. Just an Omnath. You Omnathing me. Something else. A braid. Okay. What else you got? Riftwing. A little copycat action. So now I have to draw another land to replay Massacre Worm if that's what they bounce. But I think this is a good play. They can knock Lily down to 2. The only other card we could draw that we can't play is Bolas's Citadel, so I feel okay with our odds. If it's a land, we can replay Worm. If it's not a land, hopefully we can play it. I guess it could be Jetmir's Garden. And that's a land that we also can't replay Worm with, but can at least cycle it. Opponent deciding what they want to part with. I got kind of an odd combination of cards. They're like 4 or 5 color. Just kind of random stuff so far. Riftwing, Abrade, Mind Twist, Gideon. I don't know. Looks like they disconnected. And they're back. Okay, they do bounce the worm as expected. Is it Ballista or a Spellbinder? Okay. I mean, it gets it out of our hands, so we can make them discard, and we don't have to discard. So that's something. We do draw land. Okay. So our Lily dies. We get Riftwing next turn. Probably just bounce the Signet. Get all the duels. Pretty good. Not yet, sir. There's a land. Okay, we go to 11 with Glorybringer. Next turn we go to 5. But if they exert, we don't die quite yet. Okay, they don't exert. You can just do it on the follow-up. I guess I should have made them exert. If we Masker Worm, though, they don't have the damage unless they have a burn spell. Could also treasure cruise, but I think worm is probably good. What do you got? They have a burn spell that can hit me in the face, then they win. Chandra? Chandra will do it. Wheel of Fortune. Okay. So I'm assuming they have burn. Leaving up a red. Pretty good odds they draw it. See what you got. Discarded a Lurrus and a Razor Verge Thicket. So we got Damnation. So even if they play like a creature or two here. Well, I mean, they would need a way to like exile Masker Worm or get rid of it. Because otherwise we can just attack with it. And if they trade, then we win. Because of the life loss. The fact that they're thinking this long means that there's nothing super obvious that wins them the game, so. Steam vents, okay. GG. I wonder if we hadn't hit them down to one, if that steam vents would have won them the game. a sideboard. They were just like five color silliness. Can't keep that. 18 land deck. Still get these hands. Sure. Do they have a haste creature or burn? And are we going to draw an island next turn? Thinking about just playing Ashiok. They knock it down to one, but put up to three again. If we draw an island, we can kill the 3/3. I guess we could discard the Cloud's Gate. Let's see what we exile. All right, give me a land. Knight. They showed us Knight last game, I think. Garrick, okay. Make it 3/3. Land. Perfect. It's pretty good. I think I'll play the Scarab God first. They can just sack the Blade Splicer if we play Lich, and then we have to like trade with a beast. Or let it hit us, and then they become Monarch, and then it's just not worth the risk, I don't think. I'd rather play the Scarab God. Alright, so our Ashiok's dead. We get to recur our Cloud's Gate though, bounce the token. I don't think we need the double blue that desperately. Hopefully they give it flying and attack instead of making a 1-1. We'll see. They make the 1-1. Okay. It's a card. Really? It's a strange play. You don't think you want the extra mana when you're... Okay, whatever. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and just get this. We're not gonna need anything that's that much better, I don't think. Go ahead and get the extra scry and extra drain life or whatever. Not really a drain, they lose life. I mean, worm seems good, but not this turn, obviously. So we'll go top. I guess I could look at their hand. If they're playing Harnfell, they probably want to just discard the cards anyway. Can't really attack with Scarab God that well. I'll save it. I guess I could look at their hand. The odds they have an instant or sorcery might not be that great though. Because we're playing Massacre Worm next turn, hopefully. So Soldier will die anyway. I don't think I need to use a removal on it. I was thinking like maybe Brutality it and then they have to sack something better when we play Lich. But we're playing Massacre Worm probably, so. I wonder if they wheel here. I think I'd be pretty happy if they wheeled. Decent enough chance they have a creature. And they'll only have 3 or 4 mana left. Sure. More food for the worm. So hopefully they destroy the 3-3. They go for the signet. They go for the signet. How did they know? It's really annoying. To get in there. Okay. The Wheel of Fortune is gone. Elspeth seems pretty good. What are they looking for? Ah, Minsk and Boo. I see. Yep, that just about kills me. I mean, come on, buddy. It's not like you're not playing Minsk and Boo, right? Have they played a land yet? I don't think they have. I think they can play Island. Play a Braid, too. Maybe they played a land, though. I don't know. I think they still have a land drop. So you can put me to 2 here. Somehow they haven't discarded any creatures, but they at least have the spellbinder that we killed, so we can get that back for more blockage. Could also just play Karn and make a token, but so we can't do the spellbinder trick on their draw step because they have Hornfell. Kind of negates that. Could still get it though. And we're killing Minskin Boo for sure. I guess they showed us Glorybringer, so we have to be a little bit careful. I'm gonna at least try it. I don't know. Maybe they won't realize they can. Yeah, okay. Teferi, Inquisition. Sure. Got it. So they draw another card here. GG. Oh wait, I had a flyer. Oops. Didn't mean to still had these them. I forgot they would go down to four. Whoops, whoops, whoops. Sorry, sorry, opponent. Uh-oh. Not too fast there, boy. Exile Showdown. Okay. Level him up. Level that sumbitch up. I was about to say, I didn't expect a Savannah. I was about to say, I could have played the Jetmir's Garden to kind of prevent, like, artifact removal or, like, a Dak Faden or something. Yikes, glad they can't play that. So we're guaranteed to be able to play Ashiok. But Ashiok kind of just dies, so... That's sort of a problem. All right. But if it gains us some life, it gains us some life, right? Oh god. Leveling up Alalia so it can take it out by itself. Whoops. Yeah, this game's pretty much over. They might not even attack Ashiok. They do. Okay. It's probably good for me overall. We can draw into Damnation. Yeah, I think we have to play the Lich. It draws us a card with Monarch. Really, our only out is to draw Damnation. This makes him sack a goblin. We can trade with Rabble Master or block Lelia if we want. Chump. Take 10. Yeah, I think we have to do it this way. It's a slim chance. This kind of just gives him more info, but there is a chance. Only problem is they'll get Monarch here and draw more stuff, draw more gas. So they actually are multicolor over there. Brutality. Not great. So we go to one here, potentially. I mean, if they have removal for Lich, we're dead. I knew that was gonna happen. Okay. Glad they can't play that. Alright, do you have the burn? They do not. Not yet. Damnation? Not quite. Not quite. Okay. So they're like two or three colors, it looks like, but mostly just red, like aggro. Not sure what they're playing the other colors for. I don't even know if that was correct, the time walk there. I feel like we actually prefer them to time walk on turn 2 as opposed to later. Well, they exile Lelia. And Skin Boo. Yeah, see, now time walk's actually like way worse for us. I should have let them do it. Come on, White Source. White Source or we're dead. Probably dead anyway. Is that even a white source? Kinda. Alright, so do we set up for Teferi? I mean, they're gonna pump up to 7, hit us to 9, pump up to 9, or pump up to like 10, kill us, or we're just dead. We're just straight up dead. No matter what we do. Great. Cool. Dead to Minskin Boo time walk. Yeah. Had no idea that's what was in store for us when we got beat down by Mono Red with a bunch of dual lands in the first game. But, yeah, I guess that happens.